Commissioner, Department of Agriculture, Darrell Hopkins.
Well, good morning, everyone. I'm certainly pleased to be here. Just sitting there listening to my friend and former colleague, President Stringer, I could probably sit down at this point. He really did say it all, and I just want him and all of you to know that we at Ag and Markets in the state are certainly committed to working with Scott and with all of you and Just Food to move the agenda forward on a lot of the different issues we talked about. I also want to recognize Secretary Merrigan. I had the opportunity to visit with the Secretary 2 weeks ago down in D.C. and talk about a lot of issues that are of concern to farmers and consumers as well. But really, there's a lot of opportunity here in New York State, especially here in New York City. And we at Ag and Markets are very excited to partner and work with Just Food on a lot of different issues. And as you know, getting fresh food is becoming increasingly popular, and popular for a lot of different reasons, not the least of which is health-related, but also we're trying to make the connection between organizations like Just Food, CSAs, and a lot of other organizations firsthand with farmers and people who grow the products that we all enjoy here in New York State, and making those relationships in a very tangible, very real way. And by making those relationships, we open up the need for varieties of food and what should farmers be looking at and producing here in New York State. And this allows small farms here in New York State to prosper and grow by opening up markets that may not be open to them already. And it also helps New York State keep land in production, which is extremely important for the economy, certainly upstate, and as President Stringer pointed out, it's going to be important here in New York City as well. So lots of good things are happening here at the local level, and lots of good things are happening nationally, and I'm sure that Secretary Merrigan will be addressing all of that here in a few minutes, but we in New York are on the front lines of the food revolution, and we're a big state as far as agriculture is concerned. We have a lot of diversity and a lot of market. And last year, as President Stringer pointed out, we reached a peak number of nearly 500 farmers markets here in the state. We have more winter markets than California. We have just under 100 winter markets, but I guess that stands to reason. I think we have more winter typically than they do in California. But Governor Cuomo really has been a very strong advocate to getting more fresh local foods to our families, especially the historically underserved areas of the city and state for that matter. But even before Governor Cuomo was elected, part of his platform was the Farm New York, emphasizing improvements to access to local fresh foods. And already we've done a lot on that front. The Governor's Fresh Connect Farmers Market Program, launched last year in 2011, established 11 new farmers markets now serving low-income communities from Long Island to Niagara Falls. And four existing markets included local mobile markets. These enhance better low-income communities' opportunities. And just as an example, the 100-plus-year-old North Tonawanda Market now accepts food stamps to the EBT system, the Electronic Benefit Transfer, for the first time. And we really are very grateful to Just Foods for having played a major role in that, and we certainly appreciate that, Jay. You've done a great job, you really have. And we also plan to continue the expansion of the Fresh Checks Connect program, which last year, very similar to the program that President Stringer talked about, a market where a $2 coupon is given for every $5 spent on food stamps through the EBT program. Now, the EBT program, the Electronic Benefits Transfer, allows open-air farm markets to accept food stamps based, and benefits has enjoyed a tremendous success since it was launched. Growing from 86 markets with 31-plus terminals and nearly $300,000, the EBT sales in 2008 has grown to 247 markets with 76 other outlets, and has grown to well over $2 million in EBT sales in 2011. So you can see that program really has taken off, and we look forward to that continuing to grow into the future. And another program is the New York Healthy Foods Healthy Communities Fund, and a public-private partnership that establishes and provides grants and loans for commercial food markets in underserved communities. This has improved financing for new and expanded healthy food retail outlets in places like Highland Falls, Staten Island, Mount Vernon, Brooklyn, and Conklin, New York, as well as for a mobile market in Buffalo. And in his State of the State address this year, the governor also made a commitment to promote the idea of food hubs and creating a distribution on a large scale, hubs strategically located across the state. This will, and it really truly will, help make the connection between locally grown produce here in New York State from the farmers to the marketplace, and that's something that really we all should applaud as that program continues to move forward. And of course, you know, we're all aware that the Federal Farm Bill, which provides the legal framework for a lot of the funding for a variety of essential agricultural and nutrition programs here in New York State, but all across the country, is up for reauthorization this year. And our office at Ag and Markets is monitoring the progress, and we'll continue to advocate for the interests of New York State, including its farmers and all the residents, with an interest in food and nutrition, and making sure that as the Farm Bill moves forward, that the interests of New York State and the whole Northeast, for that matter, are being included. So with that, I'd like to pass off to everyone involved, especially all of you who have taken time to be here today, beyond today for sure, but Jackie and the whole organization of Just Food, it really is doing a tremendous job, and we at Ag and Markets look forward to continuing that relationship well into the future. So I just want to thank everybody again, and good luck, and I certainly hope everyone enjoys the conference as it continues to unfold today. Thank you.